Greetings, everyone. Welcome to YQS Lab. And today I will present how to create organic patterns in architecture. And as a bonus, I will teach you also how to do several type, a bonus type of organic pattern. So once you open the 3ds Max, we need to, in my tutorial, I will demonstrate how to create the pattern on a panel and how to create it on the surface of a box or a building. So to start with, in the front view, I will create a panel. And this panel, I will apply on it the organic pattern. So to create the pattern, the most important thing is to control the segments. So the segments, that's the clay one. So the segments here are almost equal, which is, they are equal, 4 and 4. So it depends on the direction of the patterns, which direction you want. So if we made this 80 by 80, so basically you have equal number of squares. So the pattern is going to be equal. Versus if you decided to increase the width segments, so the patterns will be longer this way. And so let's say we will create 20 segments here and 25 here. So once we created the segments, now we have to create our friend modifier edit poly. Edit poly allows you to control the segments. You can do whatever you want with edit poly and edit mesh, of course. So, but for to apply the patterns, we can do it fastly by creating edit poly and going to polygon modeling, and we do generate topology. Once we do generate topology, they have several patterns already built in the 3ds Max. But one of the most important ones, which I, in my opinion, you will use a lot, is the organic one. So you can do the skin pattern, which is, this is the skin pattern. It's equaled, or it's organic biomimic pattern. So of course you have several ways to edit on this. You can just go back to plane and change the pattern. But if you did that, this deformation would occur. So short brief story, you can do it by deleting the edit poly and do it back again and create the skin. So you created something that is different. And if you want to add more holds to the patterns, you can apply more than one pattern. You can select the holder and it create basically something similar to that. So let's undo the holder pattern and edit poly and skin. So we can go back here. We do several times. I wish I okay. So I added the edit poly. I deleted edit poly. So now this pattern will be similar to this, but in more organic way. So we will add skin to it, but we will create turbo smooth. So if we did the turbo smooth, it's going to look like this versus if we separated the patterns and we, of course, made it by polygon and we did something like this. You can use this pattern to make shades and screens for your building. So let's add turbo smooth. Now your turbo smooth, the pattern became radial. That's the one of the bonus patterns. You can go here. Of course, you can separate the segments. You can edit, do edit poly and polygon, and you can just delete them. And if you want to have thickness to it, you can just add shell. And this shell gives it thickness. So you can use this pattern everywhere. If you want more organized patterns, there are several here you can play with and see which one would be applicable in your case. But there is something I need to inform you with. When you do these patterns, it works on surface only. So if you have a box and this box, let me do this. You can use this as a diagram pattern too. And delete, and you give it shell for thickness. So this way it works that way. But if what if your building is it's a more boxed structure, and you want to apply this pattern to one of your sides of this building, and let's go to that building and try to add segments everywhere. Of course, hide segments. And if you go there and you did edit poly, and this edit poly, accordingly, you went to polygon modeling, generate topology, and you decided to add the skin, this will happen. So to avoid having this error type of thing, I would recommend you, before you add any segments, make them the basic as equal ones segments everywhere. And do edit poly. And let's say you want to edit on this side to add the patterns. This is your south or west, southwest side, and you want to have shade on this face. So what you're gonna do is select this edge and detach. Detach this polygon. And once you do this, you can select edge. But the problem now, we don't have segments here. So the easiest way to do the seg to add segments, lengths and widths, segments and height, you can select the two edges and go to connect, connect, and click on the settings. And now you can increase the numbers of the segments, and you can actually change the distance between them. And if you want to change the direction of them, we can too. But for now, you're gonna do it this way. And we added 20 segments while they are already selected. I recommend to click again on connect to create the vertical ones. So if you want to add the segments to go till the end, just select the two segments, and let's add the side will be 30 segment. And yes. So once we have this now, you can basically add the skin pattern to it. So you can now select all and do inset by polygon. And now you can, what I recommend you to do is to keep this as it is. Don't delete the polygon and do right click, clone. Copy and go to that copy and give it a lattice. And once you do this lattice, it's going to give you the emollients for it. And you can control the segments type and the widths and size. And you can increase the segments to make it as radial or sharp as you want. Four sides or a tube type of segments, and this way you created the pattern here. You can do it in all sides. You can separate. That's my recommendation to support to delete or detach this side first, and then this side. You select edge, control by connect segments. It gives you this number of connections and ages, and do it this way. And now you can add this type of patterns, and you can try to integrate both patterns. So it gives you, you can start with the skin and add to it some of the age line, and then you can do a turbo smooth if you want. Again, we need to select all, inset by polygon, Doesn't need to be all that inset, okay? And you can say turbo smooth. And once you do this, you hit pulley. In this case, I recommend you to delete it. And you go there, select all or whatever. You can just right click clone and lattice. I always make the joint zero, and because I can control this later. But yes, so you can have a pattern that looks like geometrical interactions or intersections between the segments. So you can create several concepts and design ideas by using these patterns. Thank you so much. And if you needed any type of buildings that you would like me to build and do the modeling for it, just write in the comments the name and I will try my best to create that for you. Thank you so much.